Hello everyone, hope you guys are doing great. Today's video is going to be about some of the best open source applications which offer some incredible and unique features. And what I will do is that I will just give you a brief overview about the features as well as a quick tutorial for some of the applications I'll be covering in this video so that you get a better idea about these applications, and it will also help you to use these applications in a much easier way. And if this is your first time on this channel, please make sure you hit the subscribe button and turn on channel notifications so that you get notified whenever I post a new video. Now let's get the video started and take a look at all these amazing applications. You might have seen a lot of gallery applications for Android, but the first application which we are going to see beats almost every gallery application out there. Like if you want a simple gallery application for your Android device but with advanced features, then this is the application you should be looking for. This application is known as AIMS and it can handle multiple media formats like the usual JPEGs, PNGs or MP4 files, or even the more advanced ones like TIFF, SVG and AVI files. It can also identify motion photos, panoramas, 360 videos or even GeoTIFF files. And if you take a look at the main interface, it is as simple as any other gallery application out there, but it gets interesting when you explore all the features. For example, this zooming feature here, it's very smooth. And on the left panel, you get all these categories like videos, screenshots, albums, and even the country option, apart from different tags you put for your images. And if you open any image, you get some interesting options like converting through different formats and sizes, or adding images as shortcuts to your home screen, or printing images as PDF. I think we don't need any image converters anymore if you have this application in your Android device. And if you take a look at the application settings, well, this is where it gets better and better. You can customize almost everything here, like the navigation related settings or the settings related to thumbnails. You can also customize quick actions, accessibility settings, and even change the display settings like theming and all. And I must say that this is the best gallery application I have tried in my Android device, and this is my personal recommendation for you guys. So make sure to give this one a try. When it comes to keyboard applications, there are a lot of keyboard applications out there, both open source and closed ones. But when it comes to unique keyboards, there are only a few of them, and the second application which we are going to see comes in that unique category. This application is known as Irregular Expressions, and it's completely unique in what it offers, and it can change the way you send your text message or update your Twitter or Facebook status. This keyboard application offers 30 plus font styles which can help in giving a new look to your message or status updates. It also provides you four different keyboard layouts where QWERTY is set by default and would be perfect for most of you guys. You can also change the keyboard height to match your typing style, and there is not much you can change in the application settings here. There are no suggestions or language settings. It's a very simple but effective keyboard application and is completely open source as well. This keyboard can also help you in creating some unique titles and names. For example, if you are into mobile gaming like PUBG or BGMI, you can create some unique names with this keyboard application. So if you want to give a unique look to the text that you type, this is the keyboard application which might help you in that. The third application which we are going to see is an email application, an advanced email application to be more specific, because it offers some incredible features and is completely open source as well. This email application is known as Fair Email and it can handle multiple accounts. It's privacy and battery friendly and has a nice material design and consumes less data as well. There are tons of settings inside, but I won't be going into detail about all of them because you rarely need to go through most of these settings and it is better to keep them at the default values. But what I will do is that I will just give you a quick tutorial about adding your email accounts, for example a Gmail account, so that it will be easier for you if you are planning to use this and should actually use this one instead of other email applications, because this is a really good application. Now let's move to the tutorial first. So when you open this application for the first time, you'll be welcomed with these terms and conditions, and after you tap on this agree button, it will take you to this wizard where you can add different email accounts. And as you can see, it's mentioned that setting up an account is very easy and there is no need to change any settings. Now before adding any account, it's better to grant these permissions first so that this application runs smoothly. The first permission is related to contacts, which is an optional permission and depends on you if you want to enable this or not. And the second permission is the important one, because you should disable battery optimization for this application so that you receive your emails on time. So I'll just allow this permission here. Now if I type on this wizard, you can see for all these accounts like Gmail, Outlook and Yahoo, you have this open authorization option. So I'll just tap on this Gmail account here and it will take me to the next step. And in this step, you need to authorize your Gmail account here. You can tap on this select account here and choose your Gmail account and press OK. And you would require to grant these permissions like sending and composing emails and all. You can go ahead and press allow, and add your Gmail account will be this added here. You can take a look at the settings like themes and all, or you can just tap the back button and it will directly take you to your inbox and you can start using this application normally. So that's all about the tutorial here, and if you have any questions regarding this tutorial, please let me know in the comment section below. Now let's go ahead and take a look at the next application. If you want to choose any complex password for your account, sometimes what will happen is that we run out of ideas and we just stick with the simple password. But the last application in today's list is an amazing password generator application known as vanced, which can help you in generating some complex and unique passwords very easily. It's an offline application and is completely open source, and it does not store the passwords, it only helps to create them. So this is how the main interface of the application looks like, and you get different options for generating the password. You can stick with a single option like lowercase for example, or you can combine different options together like lower and uppercase together with numbers and special characters. And you can just tap on this generate button at the bottom and it will keep generating different passwords for you. You can go ahead and copy the password and save it. This is a really unique and an interesting application, and being completely open source, you can add this one to your list. So this rounds up today's video on some of the best open source applications, and I hope that this video is helpful for you guys. And if you want to try any of these applications, please check the video description for all the download links. And this will be the second time in a single video I'm asking you guys to subscribe. So if you are new to my channel, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and turn on channel notifications so that you get notified whenever I post a new video. And you guys can take a look at my other videos as well. I'm sure you'll find them helpful. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you soon in my next video.